All right, let's get it started in game two, Benedictine and Illinois Tech. Glad you're along from the Village of Lisle Benedictine University Sports Complex. Justin Sosa starting in this one, and his first delivery is down low, ball one. We are underway at, what time is it? 2:47, there we go. Glad to have you for this one. Benedictine trying to sweep after winning the opener 6-4. And it's a 3-0 count to start. Now 3-1. Two and two the count. Fouled away. I was going to say, it'd be strange to be swinging on 3-0. Justin Sosa starting, and apparently that one was a little bit off. Bouncer to second base, controlled by Kyle Mitter, who will throw to first for the out. Orlando Cardenas wand to the plate. First pitch is in for a strike, nothing in one. Foul back, and it's now 0-2. Pitch on the way from Sosa, off the fists, behind second base. Patterson secures. And there are two outs. Zach Dickey steps to the plate. And a swing and a miss in the first pitch, 0-1. Swing and a miss to make it nothing and two the count. Sosa makes quick work here in the top half of the first. Benedictine batting for the first time. The Benedictine lineup is on the screen. A little different here for game two. Jack Feely leads off in center. Logan Shepherd is the DH. Shepherd will bat second. In the three spot, Jimmy McLaughlin in right field. Jack Surin, the cleanup batter. He's behind the plate. Damon Castillo starting at first base. Brendan Norberg with the start in left field here for game two. Bottom three, Cam Falk with the start at third. He'll hit seventh. Chase Patterson at shortstop, batting eighth. And Kyle Mitter at second base rounds out the lineup for Benedictine. As Jack Feely makes his way to the plate. Against the starter for Illinois Tech here in game two. Roberto Carcelli, first pitch, lined into center field, a base hit. That's the way to get it started for Jack Feely here in game number two. Logan Shepherd, first pitch swinging, hanging into right field, and a sliding catch made by Courtney. And Jimmy McLaughlin will step to the plate. McLaughlin's going to step out. One away, runner aboard. Bottom of the first in game number two. Carcelli throws over. On the season, he's 3-2 with a 4.06 ERA. Six start today, 37 and two-thirds innings. Only five walks, 26 strikeouts. Another throw over from Carcelli. Feely extending his hitting streak with that single to start. There's another throw coming over, closer this time. Entering today, Feely was at 13, so he's now hit safely in 15 straight and reached in 16 straight. As McLaughlin takes low 1-0. Just underway here in game two from the Village of Lyle Benedictine University Sports Complex. The 1-0 up off the outer edge, two balls and no strikes. McLaughlin looking down towards Adam Smith, hands on his hips, coaching at third. Sunglasses on for the junior McLaughlin. Go, Jimmy, come on, kid. Outfield deep and straight away for the most part. A lot of throws to first base. Jones in center is about, I would say, two or three steps to his left of where he would be normally. A little warmer here for game two, 65 degrees. Still under sunny skies. Beautiful weekend here in Chicagoland. It's a 3-0 count on McLaughlin with one away and a runner at first. Benedictine winning the opener by the score of 6-4. Three zero. Outer edge, strike one. Hey, There's a 3-1. It's popped up on the infield. Feely was moving. He has to sprint back to first. The shortstop, Bledsoe, is all the way over to make the call. And two down.
Now batting, catcher number 9, Jack Surin.
Jack Surin steps to the plate. Scoreless ball game in the first. There goes Feely. Pitches over the outer edge. Throw from Casey. On point. Safe. Stolen base. And that'll immediately draw the ire of the Illinois Tech dugout. Ed Zeeford out to argue. Back to second, and it slips over the outside corner, nothing and two. One, two pitch, swing and a miss at a high one, strike three. Runner left, we head to the second in a scoreless game. The Illinois Tech starting lineup is on the screen for you. Benedictine starter is Justin Sosa. He made quick work of Illinois Tech to start. Second inning, no score. First pitch to Nick Bledsoe is over the outside corner, strike one. And now 0-2. Sosa's last start was against North Central in a non-conference game. He's 1-0 on the season with a 5.49 ERA. 23 strikeouts and 19 2/3. Did he go? No. This time he does. Strike three. One away. Brandon Bennett steps in. He homered in the opener. Takes the first pitch in, 1-0. And now downstairs, ball two. I'm Tim Calderwood with you at TC Popcorn on Twitter, at Benue Eagles on Twitter as well today. Into the hole, left side. Patterson has to scamper right, throws to first, and a stretch by Castillo. Two away. Five up and five down for Sosa on the hill. As Ted Howell steps to the plate. All one. In for a strike, 1-1. See, right two on the swing. Down and away. Two and two. And that'll fill her up. Out away, right side, carrying out of play. Two outs in the second, Sosa with a payoff. Another one fouled away by Howell. Up high, ball four. So a base runner for Illinois Tech. First one today. Courtney, first pitch, swinging a liner down the right field line, past McLaughlin all the way to the wall. Howell is going to be frantically waved around. The throw in will be cut off, and Illinois Tech takes the lead. On the first hit today, it's an RBI double to make it a 1-0 lead. Michael Courtney drives him home. John Casey to the plate, didn't play in the opener. 13th start of the season. Runner at second base with two away, 1-0 Illinois Tech. Strike one, what do they say, those two out walks, right? And those are some very close pitches to Howell. Courtney took advantage with a double into the right field corner. Oh, The 0-1. Tardy fouled away right side, 0-2. Little bit low, one ball and two strikes. One, two pitch upstairs. Again, the patience for Illinois Tech, it showed in game one, forcing Schramm out of the game after only five innings. Casey at 184, no homers, four knocked in. The 2-2, swing and a miss, strike three. So a runner left, but a run in as well. We played an inning and a half. Illinois Tech in front, 1-0. One nothing Illinois Tech early in game two as Damon Castillo steps to the plate. Up-to-date numbers for Castillo on the season. He's hitting .222. Two homers and seven driven in. Roberto Carcelli delivers. First pitch is a breaker. Tapped foul at the plate, 0-1. Nothing and two on Castillo. Carcelli throws. Down and away. Even at two balls and two strikes. Soft liner into center field, a base hit. Castillo aboard to begin the second for Benedictine, representing the tying run. Brendan Norberg steps in. starting game two in the sixth spot in the order, and he has a knock. Castillo heading for third. The throw comes into second, and Norberg is safe there. The aggressive nature of Adam Smith on the bases for Benedictine. First pitch is inside to Cam Falk, ball one. Did not play in the opener, at least get an at bat anyway. Came on defensively late. He's hitting 235. No home runs and six knocked in. One and one. Hit hard on the ground, a second. Bennett picks it up, throws to first. One away, but a run will score. That's 1-1 on the RBI ground out. Chase Patterson to the plate. Corners in, middle halfway. Squeeze out in front of the plate. It's picked up. Didn't move far enough. And the out will be recorded at the plates. So the unsuccessful squeeze means there are two outs, but we are tied at one apiece. Low and away, wild pitch will move the runner into second base. Oh, Bunt off the screen and coming back at us. 0-1 the count. One ball game in the third as Sosa deals, and a bouncer to the right side is foul, 0-2. First at bat for Jones today. Little bouncer hugs the line, stays fair. Sosa picks it up. Safe, they say at first. And here comes Adam Smith. Look out. He is in the face of the umpire at first base. Biggest point being perhaps ask for help. And now the umpires will discuss. And so they'll overturn it. Now they call him out. And so the debate will be taken up by Illinois Tech's head coach. And Ed Ziefert is beside himself. So base is clear, one away. After the dust settles, arguments from both sides. Lineup turns over and the first pitch is down low for a ball, 1-0. Jacob Sorensen at the plate. 1-0 pitch is fouled back, and it's 1-1. Sorensen was 1-for-3 with a walk and an RBI in game one. The 1-1 pitch over the outside corner, strike two. Down and in, two balls, two strikes. One away, third inning in a 1-1 game. Important for both teams, if you haven't gathered, based off of the reactions from both dugouts and both head coaches. Strike three over the corner. Orlando Cardenas Juan to the plates. He was 0-for-4 with a strikeout in game one. Two outs, base is clear. Third inning today. Popped up on the first pitch, a mile high. Sosa will point it out. Castillo makes the call. First baseman trudges onward and makes the play. And it's 1-1 to the bottom of the third.
Being a part of the different activities and organizations that I've been a part of, I'm actually able to see myself where I'm like, hey, I actually can make a change. I'm one person that can make a difference.
Division III has helped me to develop teamwork skills, critical thinking skills, time management skills.
It's not just about basketball or it's not just about school. It's about developing yourself as a person altogether.
Jack Feely leads off, bottom of the third. 1-1 game. Carcelli's first pitch. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Feely in the opener today was 2-for-4, scored a couple of runs, drove in a run. Had a triple to his credits. The 0-1 delivery, wave and a miss, nothing in two. Low and outside, 1-2 the count on Feely, who owns one of the 3 Benedictine hits here in game 2. Pitch on the way, bounce to third. Backhanded by the shortstop, Bledsoe, low throw, dug out. And there's one away. Logan Shepherd, the batter. Shepherd entered action today, hitting 292 with a home run and 5 RBIs. Up next for Benedictine is a double with Aurora on Monday. Shepherd takes up ball one. He's 0-for-1 so far today, batting as the DH. And a strike, 1-1. Carcelli deals and a pop into short left. A little miscommunication in the outfield, but the catch is made and there are 2 outs. Jimmy McLaughlin to the plate. Up and away, ball one. McLaughlin 0-for-1 in this one. A grazer over the outer third, a ball and a strike. Up and outside, ball two. Line in a center field, a base knock. Fourth Benedictine hit today. Oh, joy. Yes, there's a microphone there, kids. Jack Certain to the plate. Oh, cool. Let's drop it onto the field. Throw over in time. Drake. Another throw over to first base. Look out. A hit by pitch. Places runners at first and second with 2 away. Go ahead run in scoring position as Damon Castillo steps to the plate. 1-for-1 today with a run. Three. First pitch, breaker to Castillo, locates strike one. Up high to even the count, one ball, one strike. Everybody holds on the spin move from Carcelli. Two and one. Probably not the man you want to be falling behind. Again, the middle infielder's Deke. Castillo with a line drive to left center field. That's going to fall and roll all the way to the wall. McLaughlin will score. Right behind him comes Surin. He's in without a throw. Throw is back into second. They'll get Castillo leaning, but I believe they'll count the run. And now the umpires are going to discuss, will they count it or no? So after a conversation, they do indeed count both runs. It'll be a two-run double for Damon Castillo. First pitch to Zach Dickey is inside, ball one. Have I mentioned that this is an intense contest? Because this is really intense. Into the air, left side, and out of play, one and one. Both coaches have been out repeatedly over and over again. One pitch, up high, ball two. Dickey is 0 for 1 with a strikeout today. Sosa, 4 strikeouts through his first 3. And he's one pitch away from number 5. In the air to deep center field. Backing, though, is Feely, shy of the warning track to make the catch, one away. Nick Bledsoe steps to the plate. Leading hitter in the conference does not have a hit today. Knock on wood. He is 0 for 5 combined between both contests as he takes the first pitch from Sosa upstairs, ball one. And now 2-0 as it misses away. Here comes the 2-0. Center field, right at Feely. Two away. Two outs. Base is empty in this 3-1 ball game. Brandon Bennett's first pitch lined foul, first base side, 0-1. Bennett with a home run in the opener. It's 0-1 on the ground out so far here in game two. Here's the 0-1. Outside, a ball and a strike. Off the hands, foul ground, first base side. Castillo over, and he'll squeeze it to retire the side. Home side of the fourth, 3-1 Benedictine. Brendan Norberg set to lead off in the bottom half of the fourth. 3-1 Benedictine. First pitch is outside, ball one. Roberto Carcelli on the hill for Illinois Tech here in game two. Norberg into center, Jones backing up, drifting left and making the catch for the first out. Garcelli at 6'1" on the hill. He's a sophomore. Batter is Cam Falk for Benedictine. Takes the first pitch low, ball one. Line down the line and left and foul. Boy. Falco for one, but he has driven in a run today. As he fouls this one away, one ball and two strikes. One away, fourth inning, Carcelli to the plate. Check swing, no on appeal. Two and two. The pitch. Up, full count. Foul to the left side. The payoff, knocked into the netting. Illinois Tech scored the first run in the second. Benedictin tied it in the bottom of the inning and then added two on a double from Damon Castillo in the third. And it is a 3-1 advantage. As Falk fights off another one. Cam Falk in his 22nd game this year. As Benedictine looks to make it seven straight. Popped into short center. Jones coming on and he will make the play. Two outs. Chase Patterson to the plate. He was 1-for-3 in game one, did score a run. So far here in game two, Patterson is 0-for-1 with a ground out. He takes up high, ball one. That, of course, was on the attempted squeeze play. The 1-0, popped foul. 1-1. Patterson takes and it grazes the outside corner. Strike two. Lined into center field. That's going to fall in for a base hit. So two out single for Chase Patterson as Kyle Mitter steps to the plate. Bunt, good one, puts it down. Throw from Cardenas Juan, not even close to in time. It'll be a bunt single, and Benedictine has runners at first and second now with two away. Seven hits on the board for Benedictine. Mound visit. Jack Feely to the plate. Two on, two outs, 3-1 Benedictine. Inning number four, the wind howling out to right. Carcelli's first pitch to Feely. Skip to the left side, diving pickup. Cardenas one, throw, save! They're loaded. Back-to-back infield hits from Benedictine. And here comes Ed Ziefert out of the dugout. I don't know what he's going to the home plate umpire. What could he be arguing here? I mean, the play at first? I didn't think that one was close. They're loaded for Logan Shepherd either way. Shepherd did not play in the opener. He's hitting 292 with a homer and five driven in on the year. He is 0 for 2 today. First pitch, off the hands, foul, nothing and one. Remember against Rockford, it was Logan Shepherd who cleared the 402 sign in center field to tie the ball game in the eighth inning, in a contest Benedictine would win in 10 by a 2-1 score. Here's the 0-1. Hit hard to second, but right at Bennett. And Benedictine leaves the bases loaded. We're going to the fifth, 3-1. As we advance to the fifth inning here in game two of our doubleheader, let's look at some scores elsewhere around the conference. How about this one? A bit of a surprise, although the result is what you would expect, but Concordia Chicago, an 11-10 winner today over MSOE in game one of their doubleheader. Again, 11-10 in game one. Aurora with a 5-2 win over Marion. Concordia, Wisconsin falling to Lakeland 6-2. Wisconsin Lutheran knocking off Dominican 7-6, so those are some surprise scores. It was Rockford 4 and Edgewood 3. First pitch to Ted Howell is fouled away to the right side as we get underway in the fifth, with Benedictine leading by the score of 3-1. Game two scores, Concordia Wisconsin with a 2-0 lead at Lakeland, that's in the fifth. Rockford and Edgewood are even at one apiece in the second. Now it's 0-2 on Howell. Aurora and Marion are all even in the fourth at two aside. And Concordia Chicago and MSOE are just underway in their second contest. So get this. It was a walk-off win for Concordia Chicago over MSOE. MSOE scored 7 runs combined between the 8th and the 9th to come from behind and tie that game at 10 apiece. It was 8-2 going into the 6th inning, and Concordia Chicago needed to walk off with a win. 2-2. Those are the baseball scores from around the conference today. As this count fills, women's lacrosse team fell this morning in Minnesota to Augsburg after losing to Hamlin yesterday. And And he lost him after being ahead 0-2. Visit BenUEagles.com for all the details. Hit the follow button at BenUEagles on Twitter as well. On the softball front, Concordia, Wisconsin, a 7-3 victory over Benedictine in game one today. Concordia, Wisconsin is regionally ranked, and they lead 2-1 in the fourth inning of game two. Michael Courtney batting. The 0-1, down and away. Good pick by Surin to freeze the runner at second base. High fly ball in the air, carrying to right center. Going to be trouble. McLaughlin's back, reaches, it's over his head up against the wall. Courtney into second with a double. And with nobody out, the tying runs are now in scoring position. It's just the second hit surrendered by Sosa today. John Casey steps to the plate. First pitch into the air, right side and out of play. 0-1. Casey did not start the opener. He's 0-1 here in game two against Sosa with a strikeout. Strike two on the outside corner. O-2 pitch upstairs. Lefty beginning to throw for Benedictine in the bullpen. It is Simon Harold, who has been emerging over the last couple of games. Second and third for Illinois Tech with nobody out. Off the hands into the netting. Game one catcher was Ricky Acevedo. Casey here in game two, he's a freshman out of Lake Zurich. The 1-2. Good spot, but Casey watches, and we're even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Illinois Tech was in the Wisconsin Conference last year. This season, a full member of the Northern Athletics Collegiate Conference. The 2-2 is away to fill the count. I was talking to Ed Ziefert before the ball game. I said, well, how'd you like the WIAC? Which, of course, is one of the prominent conferences in the country. And he said, I loved it because we only had to travel once because of all the weather in Wisconsin last spring. Of course, that one trip was 6 hours to Stevens Point, but still. 3-2 pitch. Into short left, could be trouble. Norberg looking for it. Backing on it is Patterson, and he'll make the catch. One away. Potentially, being a member of the WIAC could have helped Illinois Tech for a year. They did take their beatings a little bit in the WIAC last season, but when you see that kind of competition on a regular basis, it can only prepare you for what's to come. Darius Jones to the plate. He was 0-3 in game one. One gone, runners at second and third. First pitch is up and away, ball one. This comes down to the simple game of situational baseball. You work on this regularly with the runners in scoring position and less than two outs. Sosa starts open as he readies. In the 1-0, bunt attempt, pulling back and taking a strike, 1-1. That was interesting. Wasn't a squeeze play. Falk is slightly in at third, right at the edge of the grass. The middle is back. In at first is Castillo. The 1-1, popped foul, 1-2. Benedictine with 8 hits in the ball game. Illinois Tech just 2. 3-1 Benedictine in front, but a chance for Illinois Tech to potentially tie it up here. As Sosa sets. And the 1-2. Swing and a miss, strike 3. Two outs. Jacob Sorensen to the plate. An opportunity for Sosa to escape. Swing and a miss, strike one. Sorensen 0-2 in this one with a strikeout. Second and third with nobody out. There are now runners remaining at second and third with two away. And a 1-1 count on Sorensen. Leadoff man for Illinois Tech. Sorensen, a sophomore out of Minnesota. The 1-1. Just outside, ball two. Big moment for Sosa. Swing and a miss, 2-2. Perhaps he senses the end of his outing as his last couple of fastballs seem to have a little something extra on him. The 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike 3. Second and third, nobody out, and Sosa escapes. We are halfway home. Benedictine 3, Illinois Tech 1.
At Benedictine University, we believe one person can make a huge difference in the world, that discovering your purpose is essential to success, that you should love what you do and be ready for anything, that a quality, values-based, well-rounded, liberal arts education should be affordable. We believe that you should learn to think for yourself and not follow the crowd, that exposing yourself to diversity helps you be a better world citizen and provides more opportunities for you to grow while being of service to others, that the Benedictine values and hallmarks lead to a richer, fuller life, that you should spread your wings and be all you are meant to be. We believe that you are important enough to be known by name, nurtured, and supported while you figure all this out. At Benedictine University, we believe in you and make sure you receive an education with heart.
What a job by Justin Sosa for Benedictine. Second and third, nobody out. And he escaped without allowing a run. We're in the bottom of the fifth. It's a 3-1 Benedictine advantage. I'm Tim Calderwood with you from the Village of Lisle Benedictine University Sports Complex today. Jimmy McLaughlin will lead off for Benedictine here in game two. First pitch, he is inside, ball one. McLaughlin one for two in this one with a run scored. As he pops up the 1-0 into shallow left. And a sliding catch made. Jack Sir into the plate. Strike one. A ball and a strike. Over one in the game with a run. He's been hit by a pitch and struck out. And two away. Damon Castillo to the plate. Two outs, fifth inning, 3-1 Benedictine. Castillo with the first pitch, bouncer to third. Cardenas Juan golfs it up and throws to first to retire Castillo for the first time today. A quick fifth, we're on to the sixth. 3-1, Benedictine. New pitcher for Benedictine, Simon Harold, third outing. Two innings, three strikeouts, and a dirty, dirty deuce, which is to say a curveball. He takes over for Justin Sosa, who in five innings allowed one run on two hits, walked two, struck out six. First pitch, off the end of the bat, fouled into the backstop. 0-1, and away we go in the sixth. With Benedictine in front by the score of 3-1. Orlando Cardenas Juan is 0 for 2 in the ball game. The 0-1 at the knees over the inside corner, nothing in two. Low, one ball, two strikes. Harold out of Shorewood, 6'1" freshman and a lefty. The 1-2. Off the end of the bat, short center field, Feely coming on and making the catch. Harold's the first lefty today for Benedictine. K Game one pitchers for Benedictine. Alex Schramm, Ryan Littlevez, Ty Laramatis, and Marty Maves, all right-handers. Zach Dickey to the plate. 0 for 2 with a strikeout as he takes the first pitch. Strike one. Low one in, a ball and a strike. Swing and a miss at a high heater. Strike two. Dickey was 1 for 2 with a run and a strikeout in game one today. And the curveball just misses down. The 2-2. Full count. Payoff pitch. Golf to the right side, out of the reach of Mitter and into the outfield. One out base runner for Illinois Tech on just the third hit today. Nick Bledsoe to the plate. Ryan Littlevez begins to throw in the left field corner. He pitched in the opener. And we're going to have a pinch runner at first base as well. First pitch outside and low, ball one. Claudio Lobreco pinch running at first base. Hit to left, Norberg comes on. And he will make the catch. Two away. Quick throw to first, and Lobreco is back in. Up high. Inside corner. Ball and a strike on Bennett, who homered in the opener. The 1-1, inside and low. And it is 0 for 2 in this one. As he skies the 2-1 into left center. Feely converging with Norberg, and it'll be Feely to retire the side. We're through 5.5. It's a 3-1 Benedictine lead.
Hey, I just wanted to get good grades and to do well. But it also made me realize that I have a lot of career goals.
You're there to get a full college experience, not only participate in your sport, but participate in things outside of that. And it's all about growing as a person.
My coaches have helped me with figuring out who I really am. Their lives are dedicated for us to succeed.
Brendan Norberg will lead off for Benedictine in the bottom half of the sixth.
Yeah, let's see how good we are. If I don't play baseball anymore, if I lose my baseball career, after 13 or 14.
Showing bunt on the first pitch, pulling back and taking low, ball one.
You'll lose your baseball career this year. I'm better than you, so I'm more likely to continue playing baseball. Just remember that.
Fouled away to the left side. Brendan Norberg, 1-for-2 today.
You run like 3 miles an hour after most. I'm faster than you, and I run faster every time.
Low ball two.
And I don't sit in the outfield and pick on. Don't.
2-1 pitch from Carcelli over the outside corner. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Base hit through the left side. Hit number 9 for Benedictine today, the second for Norberg. Lead off man on base. Cam Falk to the plate. Falk 0-for-2 today, but he has driven in a run. Throw over to first. Close, but Norberg is back in safely. Neither team has really been aggressive on the bases other than Illinois Tech early in the opener. And the reason for that has been the competitive nature of this doubleheader. You don't want to make any extra outs on the bases. Norberg is a perfect 3-for-3 in stolen base attempts. Up high, ball one. Pitch in for a strike, 1-1. Picked him off. Norberg leaning. Pretty good move from a right-hander. Outside. 2-2. Bottom six in a two-run ball game. Full count, didn't miss by much. Lidovez continues to work in the pen. Here's the 3-2. Inside, ball four. Patterson will indeed bat. Quick throw to first. Falk back in safely. Patterson with a ground ball through the left side past his counterpart. And that's his second hit. As Benedictine with runners now sitting at first and second. And Kyle Mitter to the plate. Kyle Mitter, 1-for-2 today. First pitch, strike one. A spin, and everybody's back without a throw.
Is it true that Lauren was excited? I'm telling it. Not you. I'm going to tell that.
Really?
It's my game. She was my game.
I know, but she said, she told me, like, at the
open stance for Mitter. Carcelli paying a lot of attention to the base runners. Mitter with a liner to short center. It'll hang for Jones. And two down. Lineup turns over. Jack Feely the batter. Feely has extended his hitting streak today. And he is 2-for-3 with a stolen base in the ball game. Ball one. First and second with two down. Can Benedictine come through and potentially break this open or at least give themselves a little bit of breathing room? Lidovez is ready to go. Soft liner to center. Diving attempt, and it's out of the glove of Jones. He had it, and it popped out. Our run's going to score as Falk comes in, and it's 4-1. Logan Shepherd steps to the plate. Benedictine with a little bit of breathing room now. Runners at the corners. Logan Shepherd steps to the plate. He is 0-for-3 in the game. First pitch is low, ball one. Now a 4-1 lead for Benedictine here in the sixth. The pitch from Carcelli is up. No one's throwing right now, but it looks like there may be some action for Illinois Tech. They did not need to use a reliever in game one.
Nothing. He was talking to the coach.
And here comes the 2-0 instead of throw to first, and it skips away. That's going to allow a run to score. First error today from either side. Five to one on the board. Shepard with a roller into the hole right side. Bennett in the outfield will eat it. Running around third, freezing is Feely. Throw comes into third, and he's back safely. Going to be an infield hit, the 12th hit for Benedictine today. Jimmy McLaughlin batting. Two runs are in for Benedictine, it's now 5-1. First pitch is up high, ball one. McLaughlin, the left-handed hitter. The 1-0 pitch, up high, two balls, no strikes. The 2-0, swung on and missed, 2-1. Bottom six, 5-1 Benedictine, five unanswered runs after Illinois Tech opened the scoring in the second. Delayed steal, and it's gonna be executed as the throw went to shortstop and Bledsoe couldn't pick the short hop. The hit parade continues as McLaughlin's into the act. Here comes Shepard around. He's going to score. And it's 7-1. And the kids are loving it. Four-run outburst for Benedictine in the sixth inning. Jack Sir into the plate. Pitching change. New pitcher on for Illinois Tech, Joseph Hindy. He's a junior from Michigan. Ninth appearance for Hindy, 1-0 on the season, 7.53 ERA, a save on his line. 14 and a third innings, he's only walked two while striking out 12. But he's also allowed 18 hits and 14 runs. Jack Surin will step in, he's 0 for 2. A strikeout, he's also been hit by a pitch. Four runs in, runner at first, two away. First pitch, low, ball one. Throw over. McLaughlin is back in safely. Does not have a stolen base attempt this year. Here's the 1-0. Outside, two balls and no strikes. 13 hits on the scoreboard for Benedictine.
No! I ran it first.
Yeah, but you gave it to me, so you're a loser and you.
In this inning, really nothing that's been extremely hard hit. A lot of seeing eye singles. They count as line drives in the box score, right? Here's the 2-1. Towering fly ball in the air, carrying some to left center field. Jones has a bead on the warning track to make the catch. Big inning for Benedictine. We go to the seventh. It's 7-1. It's another appearance for Ryan Litavez on in relief. He threw in game one. Updated stats for Litavez. 12 appearances, 1-0 record. ERA just over one at 1.04. 17 and a third innings, two walks and 12 strikeouts. Benedictine scoring four runs in the bottom half of the sixth to open this up a bit. It's now a 7-1 ball game. As Ted Howell leads off in the seventh inning. So an inning of work for Simon Harrell, the allowed a hit. First pitch, a swing and a miss, strike one. Howell has walked twice today, and he has scored a run. No official at bat. Off the plate away. One ball, two strikes. Howell leading off the seventh inning for Illinois Tech. Swing and a miss, strike three. A retired for the first time today.
Now batting in right field, number 23, Michael Courtney.
Michael Courtney to the plate. First pitch in the air to deep right. Back it goes over the wall. Courtney hits the home run. It's the 15th of the season for Illinois Tech, and it's 7-2. It's only the third run surrendered by Litovez, the side armor, this season. And all three of those have come as a result of a home run. And maybe a pinch hitter here, perhaps. It is indeed a pinch hitter. Number nine, Dave Navarro, will pinch hit. Fouls away the first offering from Litovez. 0-1. Illinois Tech has homered twice in the game. I guess they homered first in the opener, and now the second home run has come here in game two. Litovez, out of South Elgin, attended St. Charles North High School. One ball, two strikes. Here's the 1-2, up and away. And the 2-2 pitch. Into the hole right side. Backhanded attempt by Castillo, knocks it down. Litovez covers. Two away. The batter is Darius Jones. Actually, he's going to be pinch hit for as well. Peter Upham will pinch hit. It is his first appearance today. Upham hitting 298. No homers and 11 knocked in. Strike one. We're in the seventh. Benedictine looking to sweep. If we win number seven in a row, heading into that big doubleheader with Aurora on Monday. Strike two. And I say big doubleheader because it's really key for both teams in their postseason hopes. Drake Berman in the pen. The 0-2. Strike three calls. Bottom seven, Benedictine with a 7-2 lead. Tim Calderwood with you from the Village of Lyle Benedictine University Sports Complex. Changes for Illinois Tech. Staying in the game to catch is Dave Navarro. Jacob Sorensen moves from left field to center field. And Patrick Day is now in left. Castillo, first pitch, swinging. Does it have the distance? Foul. 0-1, deep down the left field line. He narrowly missed his third home run in the opener, and he narrowly misses his third home run here. May have been a little bit out in front of the offering from Hindy. After a four-run, sixth-inning outburst for Benedictine, it is now a 7-2 advantage. The 0-1 pitch is inside, one ball, one strike. The 1-1. Locates over the inner edge, a good breaker from Hindy. No one else throwing for Illinois Tech. Berman up in left for Benedictine. Here's the 1-2. Swung on and missed, strike three. Brendan Norberg to the plate. Strike one. Norberg 2-for-3 today. Right arm hanging by the side of Hindy. Here comes the 0-1. Low, a ball and a strike. The 1-1, swing and a miss, 1-2. Hindy throws. Grounder to short. Bledsoe to his right. Brings it in. Low throw to first. But it's dug out. And there are two away. Cam Falk to the plate. Falk is 0-for-2 with a run, an RBI, and a walk. First pitch to him. Inside, 1-0. And now 2-0. May see some defensive swaps coming for Benedictine here as we reach the later point of the ball game as well. Here's the 2-0. Inside corner, 2-1. The plate, low and away. Full count with two outs. Nobody on in the bottom of the seventh. Boy, MSOE has given Concordia Chicago all they can handle today. number one ranked team in the country needed to walk off in the opener as Falk pops it into right. Bennett makes the call. Two steps onto the outfield grass to retire the side. And they're tied at one in the bottom of the third in game two of that twin bill. We go to the eighth. Benedictine leading 7-2.
I just wanted to get good grades and to do well. But it also made me realize that I have a lot of career goals.
You're there to get a full college experience, not only participate in your sport, but participate in things outside of that. And it's all about growing as a person.
My coaches have helped me with figuring out who I really am. Their lives are dedicated for us to succeed.
Changes for Benedictine. New pitcher, left-hander Drake Berman, his first appearance today. 7-2 Benedictine, reaching the eighth inning. Berman did not pitch in the opener, as I said. He is 0-1 on the season. This is his seventh outing. 3.65 ERA, 13 strikeouts and 12 1/3. Jacob Sorensen showing bunt on the first pitch, pulling back and taking a called strike, 0-1. Also a change for Benedictine at first base, Tyler Wojnarowski into the ball game. Wojnarowski started game one. He replaces Damon Castillo, who had a whale of a day at the plate. Nothing in two. Sorensen 0-3 with two strikeouts. And just outside. The lefty, Berman. Low and outside, ball two. Top of the lineup for Illinois Tech. Bouncer foul. They held just a 1-0 lead in this one and did not lead at all in game one. Benedictine immediately tied the ball game in the bottom of the second after that single Illinois Tech run. The other way to third, backhanded attempt by Falk, picks it up, no play, everybody's safe. Orlando Cardenas Juan to the plates. And he fouls the first pitch away. 0-1. A one pitch lined into the right field corner, falling quickly near the pen. McLaughlin over to cut. That's going to be a double for Cardenas Juan as he slides in safely. And with nobody out, there are runners at second and third for Illinois Tech. As we have a pinch hitter coming for the visitors. Actually, no, it's Claudio Lobreco, who came in as the pinch runner.
Now hitting number 15, Claudio Lobreco.
First at bat for Lobreco. Two homers, 10 driven in on the season. He's batting .295. Eighth inning, nobody out. Runners at second and third. First pitch from Berman. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Here's the 0-1. Up off the outer edge, a ball and a strike. Swing and a miss. Can Berman bear down like Sosa was able to do earlier, leaving runners at second and third? At that time, it was just a 3-1 game, and there was nobody out. Now there are runners at second and third with nobody out, but a 7-2 lead. Berman deals. Up and away. Cameron Paladinas is in the pen for Benedictine. Here's the 2-2. Strike three called. Huge strikeout for Berman. Nick Bledsoe to the plate.
No betting.
The top hitter in the conference is 0-7 in this doubleheader. He's 0-3 with a strikeout in this game, batting with runners at second and third. First pitch up, 1-0. Look back to second in the 1-0 pitch. Inside and up, 2-0. Again, don't forget to visit BenUEagles.com for all of the details on this one and the up-to-date stats. Low and in, ball three. Also wishing you and yours a very happy Easter tomorrow and a relaxing, enjoyable Sunday. The 3-0, take time. And Berman finds the zone, strike one. One pitch. Fouled away right side, 3-2. In the air, right side, foul ground. Wojnarowski runs out of room. Right, 3-2, foul back. Another payoff. Up and away, ball four to Lodum. All of a sudden, the tying run is in the on-deck circle, and Marty Maves has begun to throw. To left, Norberg looking for it, gonna drop. One run will score, two runs will score, and it's 7-4. And here comes Adam Smith out of the dugout.
Matt, I guess they don't want it.
Pitching change. Marty Maves saved the opener. It was his sixth save of the season. This is a save opportunity for him as well. Tying runs at the plates. One out, eighth inning, 7-4 Benedictine. Maves looks back to second in his first pitch. High and in, ball one. Eleventh appearance for Maves, no record, 2.61 ERA, 14 strikeouts in 10 and a third. His 1-0 pitch, rip and a miss, 1-1. One pitch, line to right center field, that's carrying, it's going to be trouble all the way up against the wall. One run's going to score. Here comes a second around, scoring without a throw as well. And my friends, We've got a one-run game on the double from Howell. Maves trying to bear down on the hill as he faces the right fielder, Michael Courtney. Courtney is 3-for-3 in the game with a homer and two doubles. Look out. First pitch. Strike one over the inside corner. Three extra base hits. Here's the 0-1. And a right, short. McLaughlin underneath to make the catch. Two down. And here is Navarro, who is 0-for-1 after entering as a pinch hitter and staying in the game behind the plates. Jack Surin is up, gesturing to his teammates. It's a one-run game after Benedictine won the opener 6-4, picking up a late insurance tally. Swing and a miss, strike one. A four-run eighth for Illinois Tech. And Maves is one pitch away from escaping with that nail-biting lead. Pick off the second. Howell's back in safely with the right hand. The 0-2, up and away. Tying run standing at second base.
Come on, Dave, what do you say here? Come on, Dave, Jake. Some big boy acts in here. Jangle me home one. Jangle me home one.
Just a bit high. Surin framed it. Marty Maves wants to know exactly where he missed. He just asked the umpire, was it up, was it out? And of course, he doesn't have to respond to that question. A lot of cases he will if a coach asks it. The 2-2, fouled away. Count is full. First base is open. However, Navarro represents the go-ahead run. The payoff. In on the hands, flicked to center, should be playable. Feely steps left, makes the catch. And Benedictine escapes with the lead. We are going to the home side of the eighth. 7-6. Chase Patterson will lead off. Benedictine leading by a run. Bottom of the eighth. First pitch down low, ball one. Patterson is 2 for 3, and this one with a run scored. The once highly touted high school prospect skies it to short left. And miscommunication is dropped. Sorensen was in left all day. Day came over, and Sorensen just flat out dropped it. Kyle Mitter steps in. You would assume this is a bunting situation for Mitter. Cardenas Juan is even with the bag at third. Mitter is 1 for 3 today. Shows bunt, pulls back, takes low, 1-0. Wrapping up game two of our doubleheader. You can see the shadow coming into play as the sun works its way downward in the sky. Should be a beautiful day tomorrow as well. Nice little early spring weekend here in Chicagoland. 7-6 Benedictine right now. Hindy looks back to second base. And the wheel play is on. They were aiming for the lead out at third base. Usually if you're going to show that, you want to pitch the ball. I mean, what's the point of showing it otherwise? Doesn't really make a lot of sense. He didn't even throw the ball, and yet he tipped his hand as to what was going to happen. And now Adam Smith calls over Kyle Mitter. So if they run the wheel again, I mean, it opens the entire left side of the infield if Mitter could find a spot. Haven't seen it as much at the college level, but one of my favorite plays professionally has become the slash. The wheel's on again, and the throw is into second. The slash is where you show bunt, pull back, and then take a hack. And if you're the third baseman charging, look out in a lot of cases. Especially with the aluminum bat, which is probably why you don't see it as much at the college level. The wheel is on, the 1-0 breaks down, and there was no indication of a bunt for Mitter. 2 balls and no strikes. No wheel here, and Mitter puts down a bunt towards third, but it's foul. 2-1. Corners in. Here's the 2-1. Mitter puts down a bunt, hugs the line, kicks foul. 2-2. So here's the question. 2 strikes, do you keep the bunt on for Mitter? He's obviously been very successful bunting the ball throughout his Benedictine tenure. I would imagine if there was one player you trust to get down a bunt with 2 strikes, it would be Mitter, the junior out of Northbrook. A 1-run lead for Benedictine at 7-6. The 2-2. Check swing. Did he offer? Yes. Strike three without an appeal. And so that's the first out as Mitter stays back in the dugout. Jack Feely works his way to the plate. Time is called. And they're just going to issue an intentional walk to Feely. Logan Shepherd to the plates. First of back-to-back lefties in the order here against the right-handed pitcher. Remember, Shepherd had the big pinch-hit home run last Saturday. He's 1-for-4 with a run and a stolen base today. And with one away and runners sitting at first and second, a spin from Hindy. Breaker locates inside corner of the knees, strike one. Two on with one out in a one-run game. Benedictine 7, Illinois Tech 6. The first conference meeting between these two teams. Ground ball to first. Look to second, I don't know what he's doing. Should have taken it to first the whole way. All right.
Now batting for right field, number 34, Jimmy McLaughlin.
Jimmy McLaughlin to the plate with the bases loaded. And time is called. Strike one over the inside corner, nothing in one. They're loaded with one away. Here's the 0-1. Down low, good block by Navarro behind the plate. No one else in the pen for Illinois Tech. It's Hindy's game here. He's only the third pitcher of the doubleheader used by the Scarlet Hawks. McLaughlin with a chance to answer. Down and in, ball two.
Oh,
2-2 as it nicks the edge. Tapper foul.
Keep fighting them off, Jimmy.
Come on, Jimmy.
Let's go 3-4. Come on, kid.
Let's go, baby.
Come on, Jimmy. Come on, Jimmy.
Time is called. Yanked foul, first base side. Indy ready for another 2-2. Inside, full count, no place to put McLaughlin. Here's the 3-2, and it's outside, ball four to force in a run. McLaughlin takes a walk. Jack Sir into the plates. Changes for Illinois Tech. First of all, on the mound, Brandon Bennett takes over. It's his fourth appearance, 4 2/3 innings. 0-1 record, 5.79 ERA. Benedictine now leading by the score of 8-6. An insurance run on the board. Bases are loaded in the first pitch. Drops in for a strike. So the other changes for the visitors. Claudio Lobreco is into the game at second base. And Orlando Cardenas Juan, actually Labrico's at third, and Orlando Cardenas Juan is now in the contest at second base. So he moves from third to second. 0-2, line into center field, a base hit. A run will score, and it's now 9-6. Tyler Wojnarowski with his first plate appearance today. Wojnarowski will bat with the bases loaded. He is 0-3 with the bases loaded this season. Low and away, ball one. Wojnarowski came on defensively here in game two. In the opener, he was 0-4 with a couple of strikeouts. One and one. He's hitting 181 on the season with two home runs and nine knocked in. Time is called. Swing and a miss, strike two. Brendan Norberg on deck. In the air to center. Sorensen makes the play. Tagging and scoring is Shepard. And it's now 10-6. Brendan Norberg batting with runners at first and second. Benedictine has put three on the board here in the bottom of the inning. The distance what was a 7-6 lead. First pitch drifts over the outside corner. Strike one to Norberg. Here in game two is 2-4. 14 hits on the board for Benedictine. Howell is behind the runner at first. As the high archer drops in for strike two. Hang in there, kid. I get two right here. Ball in play, middle. I'm coming around, Cam. On six iron. Find a hole. Okay. Outside. One and two, the count. Bennett deals. Away, 2-2. Brandon Bennett is a freshman. Attended Lincoln Way Central. And Jimmy McLaughlin a little bit shaken up at second base. Two and two with two outs. into the hole left side. Backhanded pickup, throw to first. Bledsoe retires the side. However, Benedictine comes up with three runs. That's a 10-6 game as we head to the ninth. Patrick Day steps to the plate, his first appearance today after coming in defensively. 4-for-23 on the year, that translates into a 174 if you're not a math major. And the umpire's gonna pull out the lineup card. He's already been in the game, so not necessary there, because he did come into left field when Illinois Tech was doing some screwy things defensively. I think that was before the eighth inning, maybe the seventh. First at bat today, Marty Maves. First pitch on the ground to second, hit hard, but swallowed by Mitter, who throws to first. One pitch and one out for Maves, who is in a save situation in the top half of the ninth as Benedictine looks for a seventh consecutive win and a doubleheader sweep. It would be a second straight conference doubleheader sweep. Sorensen showing bunt, pulling back and taking the first pitch low, ball one. Oh for four, two strikeouts for Sorensen in this one. The 1-0 outside, two balls, no strikes. Take all the way, 2-1. Unless they called that first pitch a strike. Looper to center field, that's gonna fall for a hit. Eighth hit for Illinois Tech today, a base runner at first in the top half of the ninth. Orlando Cardenas Juan to the plate. First pitch, inner edge, strike one called. Monday double against Aurora. Played at Wheaton College's home field in Carroll Stream. Up high, a ball and a strike. That could be a huge one, not just conference-wise, but nationally and regionally as well, especially with the way Benedictine's playing right now. The 1-1. On the ground is short. Patterson flips to second, one on to first. Double play. Ball game. Benedictine records the victory by the final of 10-6. 14 hits in this one for Benedictine. And a doubleheader sweep, 7 straight wins for all of us at the Benedictine University Athletic Department. Thanks for joining us on this Saturday. Have a very safe, happy, and relaxing Easter. Visit BenUEagles.com for all the details. On Monday, Benedictine heads to Aurora. Good night, my friends.